Hi, welcome to Blue Prism Tutorials. My name is Amir. This is part 9, working with calculation states on data items. In this session, we will learn how to work with calculation states, and also we will learn how to store values in data item states. First of all, we'll see about the calculation states. A calculation state performs basic mathematical operations on values and return from a calculation stage are stored in stages known as data items. Data items are parallelogram-shaped stages, acts as a container for values such as number, text, and dates. Let me switch to Blue Prism Virtual Workforce. Go to Studio, go to Processes, and add a new process, Create Process, and I'm giving as Practice for Calculation Stages. And I'm clicking next. And I'm giving the same description over here. Once the description has completed, I'm going to click on finish. So if you see under processes, you will find practices for calculation stage. Double click on that one. You will get a canvas over here. If you see, I'm having start and end stages. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to drag or double click on the calculation stage from the toolbar. Okay, and I'm going to link the link or giving a sequence by using link from start to calculation and calculation 1 to end. Now let me double click on the calc C1. So I'm going to give it a name as addition. So in this thing that I'm going to simply going to add two numbers and I'm going to store the values in one of the data item. Okay, so I'm just giving a basic example as 50 plus 100. Okay, first of all, if you see over here, I'm having some of the properties. Let me evaluate the expression first. So if you're going to add 50 plus 100, that I will get the result as 150 number. Okay, but if I'm going to validate it, this is the expression where expression evaluate the expression. What are the values that we are having? Is it valid or not? Now I want to go for the validate. So it will throw an error saying that the following errors exist. Stage to store the result does not exist. What does that mean? If I'm going to add these two numbers, where I have to store? I have to store somewhere in the container, right? So let me click OK as of now. And I'm going to drag data item. Okay, data item, as we said, it will store the results. Okay, as it is having a parallelogram shaped container which will store the result, right? So what I have to do, let me go to data item properties by double clicking on that one. I'm just giving the name as sum and description as sum. And what is the data type that I'm going to use? So I'm going to add data type as number and then click on OK. So let me go back to the addition properties. If you see over here, there's the store result in. Okay, what are the value that I have added? I have to store in some of the values, right? Where I have to store it? If you go over here in the data items, if you see over here, the data types will see sum which one we have added, right? Let me drag and drop into the store result in. So what did this mean? I'm going to add 50 plus 100. What is the variable 1 and variable 2? So and I want to store the results in the data item name called as sum. Okay, let me click OK. And if you see over here, in this page, in this main page, do you have any errors or not? So we can go ahead and we can check it over here. Let me click on the errors. If you see, I don't have any errors as of now. Okay, close it. Let's run the page. How can we run the page? First, we will save the page. Click on save, or by using Control S, we can go ahead. And I'm just saying as practice for addition. Okay, and I'm going to save the changes over here. And then let me go ahead and let me run the page. Start addition. If you see addition, so there's a 50 plus 100, the value has been stored over here in the 150. Let me reset once again. If you see, once I have reset, there's no values in the data item. Okay, so whatever the addition will happen, the values has to store in the data item. Let me run once again. Start addition, and then it is going to store in the values in one in data item, and then it is going to be end. This is a small kind of robot process, right? So this is one of the ways that we are going to use calculation stage and data item. Okay, if you see in the addition that what I have done it, okay, we have added two values. Now let me go to one more chain. I'm just going to give the properties. I'm just changing the properties by using calculation properties. Now I'll go for subtract. Okay, I'm just changing the same values. I'm not modifying anything as of now. I'm just using subtract. And what is the values? 100 minus 50. And you know, if I am going to, if where I want to store it, but this has name as given as sum, right? 100 minus 50 is equal to 50, right? Let me evaluate the expression. See, expression result is 50. And validate, as of now, it is the expression is valid because of we are already storing the values. What are the values that we are going to get it over here that we are going to store the results in sum? But I want a separate data item. Is there any other way that we can do? Yes, there is one more way. If you see over here, I'm going to add the data type, data items from here also. Let me go ahead and add it as a new child, right? And I'm going to rename it as subtract. Okay, so this is the data item name, and let me click it. Okay, and now I'm going to drag and drop over here. Okay, now what will happen, if you see 100 minus 50 is going to store the values in subtract data item. In previous data item, what we have done, we have just dragged and dropped on my canvas design. But now how it will happen, when you click over here itself, the data item has already inserted over here. If you see over here, the data item has been already added. Okay, now let me go ahead and let me execute this. If you see, I'm going to reset it first, and then I'm going to start it. Start, subtract, and then if you see, this value is not going to change because we're not using this data item anymore. So when I'm going to subtract the values 100 minus 50, it is going to store in the data item. Okay, now you know you can see the value as 100 minus 50 as equal to 50, that subtract value. So till now what we have done, we have seen that you know we are giving some values as physical values as 30 plus 50, and then we are going to be getting the values in some of the data items, right? Now what I'm going to do, I want to pass the data items which will store the values, and I want to subtract the basic arithmetic operation or basic mathematical operation I have to do, and then I have to store in a separate data item. How can I go ahead and do that? So what I'm going to do as of now, I'm going to deleting this data items. Okay, now what I'm going to do, I'm going to add data item to, I'm going to drag in two data items over here. Okay, and double click on the data item one. I'm going to say it as value A. If you see over here, the value A that I'm going to give it the data type as number. If you see over here, the initial value, what is the value that we are going to give it, the initial value of the data item value A. And I am going to say it as 200. The initial value. We'll check out the current value later on, and I'm clicking OK. Okay, in the same way, data 2 that I'm going to rename it as value B, and I'm going to give data type as in that is number, and I'm going to initial value as 500, and I'm going to save it. Click on OK. See, now value A having some value and value B having some number. So what I have to do, I have to subtract or add these two numbers. So let me go ahead with add, okay? And I'm deleting this expression as of now. If you see under numbers, you are having value A and value B. Let me pull them or drag and drop on the expression, plus what is the mathematical operation that I'm going to use? Addition that I'm going to do it, right? Then I'm going to value b and I'm going to evaluate the expression. Okay, if you see, if we are temporarily giving some values, let me give it as 20, okay, and then value b as 30, and then the number is 50, right? Close it. This is the working fine, and then let me go and validate. If you see, I'm not having any kind of store result that were there. What I'm going to do, I'm going to add one more child that is saying as result. And I'm going to drag this to store result in, and I'm going to save it. So clicking on OK. If you see over here, I want to add value A and value B, and then the result has to store in the values, the output has to store in result. Okay, let me reset it. Let me go ahead and let me execute that one. Start. If you see, value A having 200, value B having 500, the result is 700. Okay, this is the way that we are going to do a sample application or practice session on the calculation state. So in this session, we learned how to use calculation states and how to use data items. Thank you for watching this video. Have a great day.